चानोरमर्दनम देवकी परमानंदम कृष्णं वंदे जगद्गुरुं त्वमेव माता च पितत्वमेव त्वमेव बंधुस्य सखत्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्रविडं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव त्वमेव सर्वं गुरुदेव देव हरि ओम. We are doing the Panchadasi, the last chapter, the 15th chapter, and in that Sri Vidyaranya talks about Brahmanande Vishayanandaha. So it's essentially the enjoyment of the objective enjoyment or enjoyment of any object. That's what normal people are trying to find happiness in outside. So even that happiness comes from the Brahmananda. So it's only the glimpse of the Vishayananda is expressed on that. So that which is essentially the all-pervading, eternally present, unbroken, so akhanda, the jnana vritti, and also akhanda such chit ananda, therefore that is unbroken ananda, itself expresses as a reflected ananda in the equipments depending upon the nature of the equipment. So it is the equipment that is, whether it can reflect or not is a question, and one who is a jnani associated with that, he also enjoys as though the ananda of everyone too. And here if even in the Vishayananda, when the desire is fulfilled, then at that time only there is ananda. When the desire is not fulfilled, then that leads to the anger to the delusion, and delusion to further degradation of the human intellect. And that's what Krishna talks about in the second chapter. Jayato Vishayam Pumsaha Sangaste Shupajayate Sangas Sanjayate Kamaha. How do I get a desire? Because of constantly reflect on the same thing, I get a desire for it. Sanjayate Kamaha Kamat Krodho Bijayate. If the desire is not fulfilled, I get angry. And that's what is being raised here. That anger leads to kama kamat krodho bijayate krodat bhavati sammoha. Once you get anger, in the angry one loses the discriminative intellect. That's called sammoha. You do not know what is right, what is wrong, and that's called delusion. And in the delusion you act irrationally, and that then you will repent later. That's what is essentially Krishna talks about, says krodat bhavati sammoha sammoha sruti brahmaha. You forget who is mother, who is father, who is what, and act irrationally. And sammoha sruti vibrahmaha sruti brahmsa buddhinashaha buddhinasha pranasyati. So that is a downgrade in the down ladder. And upward also ladder is there. One can go evolve into higher up. And Shankaracharya says that in the Bhajagovindam, satsangatve nissangatvam, nissangatve nirmohatvam, nirmohatve nischalatatvam, nischalatatve jivanmuktaha. So essentially by constant reflection on the satsang or association with satsang will end up in the nissang. Nissang means detachment, and detachment is what is called vairagya, and vairagya is what Vidyaranya calls it as this shanta vritti. That is essentially a sattvic thoughts. Sattvic thoughts involves vairagyam, shanti, audaryam, ityadi. So those are the divine qualities. Daivi sampatti is the what has been mentioned as sattvic thoughts, and in the sattvic thoughts only ananda gets reflected. So siddhyed, and in the 15th sloka we discussed exhaustively, siddhyenna vet yasti dukkham asti asiddhe tat viruddhati प्रतिबंधे भवित क्रोधः द्वेषो वा प्रतिकूलतः. सो इफ इट इज नॉट achieved, what I want to desire comes, the vasanas rises as a desires in the intellect, and desires I go after and I perform action in order to fulfill my desire. So if I have a desire for a cup of coffee, then I have to get up and if coffee is not readily available, I have to make coffee. So all the activities are involved in order to fulfill the desire for coffee. And if the coffee tastes good, I'm happy. If I not taste good, then I'm unhappy. So here it can lead to the dukkham. If the desire is not fulfilled, because what I want, others also want it, and there is only limited things. Therefore, if they get and I don't get it, then I get disappointments, and therefore there is a suffering associated with in not getting the object of my desire. And result of that is pratibandha bhavet krodha. I get angry. Particularly, I give incidents where people getting promotions, where I also worked for it and I had honestly worked it, and the other fellow without work, he is getting promotion, and I will get really angry. So bhavet krodha and dveshaha va pratikulataha. That also leads to dvesha, means hatred, and pratikulataha. So in the contrary to our happiness is hatred comes, likes and dislikes. Dislike is because of not fulfilling the desire, fulfilling the desire that I want. So if I can't do anything in order to solve the problem, then I get other things also, that is discussed in the next sloka. Sloka 16. Asakyaschet pratikaraha
Vishadasyat na tamasaha Vishadasyat sa samasaha Vishadaha syat sa tamasaha Krodadishu mahat दुःखं क्रोधादिषु महाद्दुःखं सुखं शं कापि दूरतः.
together
असख्यश्चेत् प्रतीकारः विषादस्यात् स तामसः क्रोधादिषु महाद्दुःखं सुखशङ्कापि दूरतः.
together pratikaraha, pratikaraha retaliation. So if I hatred and then I had a retaliation comes also, not only I have vengefully I want to do something so that others also don't enjoy what I could not enjoy, that's called pratikar. Or the people who came me and my desired object, I want to eliminate them, that's called pratikaram. So if they got it by ill means, then the hatred and the retaliation even will be stronger. So pratikaraha, retaliation, chet, if possible. If that is not asakyaha, if that is not possible, then vishadaha syat, leads to more dejection of life itself. I struggle hard, people are coming in between, I can't do anything about it and I cannot fight it, and I get dejected in life. And most of the people suffer with the depressions and all that because of life success are not able to come the way they want it. And people get the depressions because people expect others to follow certain rules and expect others to do certain things, or expect others to meet your expectations. So I want everybody to meet my expectations, and I'm happy only if they meet my expectations. And the only problem is other people also have their expectations about that I have to meet, which I don't meet. I'm only concerned about they meeting my expectations, not worried about my meeting their expectations. So others will never meet my expectations because they have their own charter in life. And expecting them to follow and fulfill my expectations itself is wrong. So what should I do? pull down your expectations. Do what you can do. If it comes, okay. If it doesn't come, also okay. Because if you expect things, then you will be disappointed. I want my child to study hard, so I am making all facilities for his study. But he won't make use of those facilities and he wants to goof off. What can I do? I try to put discipline and all that, but still it is not interest in that. Whereas other students who do not have even that much of facilities are working hard and will be happy to if somebody provides those opportunities. So what can I do in this? Because I am having certain expectations, but they cannot meet my expectations and I get dejected, disappointed and all that problem. So what should I do? You do your duties. So niyatam kuru, whatever your obligations are as a father, as a mother, as a friend, as a sister or whatever, you do your obligations as required and do not expect anything. At least you have satisfaction that you met your duties and leave the rest to him, because Lord knows what is required. There are so many other factors that go beyond my control, and if I don't have a control, then there is nothing I can do other than prayer. So one has to be careful, and therefore karma yoga involves whatever I do, offer it to him, because he appreciates whether other people appreciate or not. Always people complain, I have done so much help to other people and nobody appreciates, and they don't really have any gratitude. If I am doing it for their gratitude, then I am only asking for trade in. If I do it for the sake of the Lord, God always have gratitude in the sense that He will bless me with happiness because of I am doing as a karma yoga, as a service to the Lord. Because Lord is in everywhere. Lord is not just somewhere in the Vaikuntha. Lord is everywhere. So anything that I do for the benefit of the society, then I am doing for the sake of the Lord. If they have that attitude, I have to make sure the Lord appreciates very well, and He does appreciate when I appreciate of my doing itself. That itself is the benefit here. So that's why karma yoga helps in purifying the mind from tamasic mind to rajasic mind to make it a sattvic mind. Asakyaschet pratikaraha vishadaha syatta tamasaha. So that leads to the vishada, that is the dejection and natural part of tamasic gunas. Saha, that depression. Tamasaha, that expression of tamo guna. So krodha aditu, so in anger etc. Mahadukkam, extreme misery, extreme suffering also comes. And sukasanka api durataha, and suspicion of joy anywhere further away, as I get all other the associated feelings, kama, krodha, lobha, moha, mada, matsaryas, all are called six enemies of the mind, and that's called arishadvargam. That means six enemies. They take me away from the sattvic mind, and that's what is essentially. More and more I go towards that end. This is provided when I am not getting this satisfaction, when my desire is not fulfilled. When the desire is fulfilled, now he is going to address that. Number 17. Kamyala abhi harsha vruttihi. Shanta tatra mahat sukham. Bhogo mahattaram labha. Prasaktavisha devahi. Together. Kamyala abhi harsha vruttihi. Shanta tatra mahat sukham. Bhogo mahattaram labha. Prasaktavisha devahi. So kamyalabhi, when the desire is fulfilled, that means the object, I worked for this and I got what I want, then I'm happy. That's true. Therefore, harsha vrittihi, a thought of joy arises in the mind. So when the desire is not fulfilled, then that leads to krodha, and krodha to moha, moha to all other, that degradation can happen. Whereas when the desire is fulfilled, then I should get be happy. So kamyalabhi harsha vrittihi, a thought of joy arises. Shanta, this is Shanta, this is a sattvic thought. So that harsham, the pleasure is, even though the rajasic mode of agitation contributed to my action, forcing me to act, and in the process when the result comes, my desire is fulfilled, then the rajasic thoughts go away. In those moments, sattvic thoughts arises because the mind is contented. It is a tripti, even though it is momentary, it is, I am satisfying, or because I was asking for a good hot cup of coffee in the morning and the coffee arrives, it's so good, and when I have the good sip of coffee, my agitations are calmed down and I am back to sattvic mind without longing for or wanting mind or desiring mind, a mind that is contented mind, that is a sattvic mind. So kamya labha harsha vruttihi, so a thought of joy arises. Shanta, that is called the shanta vruttihi. Tatra mahasukam, so there in that mahasukam, a great joy happens when the sattvic thought of contentment thought, which is called sattvic thought, arises when the desire is fulfilled. So mahataram and mahatsukam bhogi, when that object of desire is enjoyed, so mahataram, superior than even before lapa, that complete satisfaction is there. Even labha prasakti, even when there is a desire to possibility of getting success, that itself gives a joy. So when I am progressing, I want to achieve, then the very process of progressing also, and the vision that I am going to get, what I am going to get, even before I got it, the happiness starts already. So labha prasakti, even the very possibility of getting the object of desire, Ishat Yevahi, there is a bit of joy in that, becoming sattvic thoughts are already coming in the process. And Ishat Yevahi, and so the Mahataram Labham Prasaktam Ishat Yevahi. So whether desire is coming, it's already coming, the sattvic thoughts are coming and I am getting happiness, but when the object is desired, when I get the greatest happiness. So there is a degree of happiness in this scale also, before I get the very, very possibility of getting it, and once I have realized that I am going to get it, then before get itself, I am start becoming happy already. Once I got it, then the highest pleasure comes into picture. So there is a hierarchy, taratamyam, taratamya bedha, that means there is a degree of hierarchy of that, and that's possible only in the Vishayananda. Next 18, mahattamam virakte tu, mahattamam virakte tu, vijyanande tadiritam, vijyanande tadiritam, evam shantau tathau dharye, evam shantau tathe dharye, krodha lobha nivaranat, together, mahattamam virakte tu, vijyanande tadiritam, evam shantau tathau dharye, krodha lobha nivaranat. So virakte, So here the degree of happiness is even before I got it, I am already getting happiness. When I get it, I am more happy than even just thinking of I am going to get it. So there is hierarchy. Now he says here, more than that, virakti, when I have a dispassion for it, doesn't matter, I am beyond all that, whether I get it or I don't get it, if in that situation, then virakti, in the dispassion, indeed, mahattamam, the happiness is even more, because that's what the Upanishad says, when my mind is contented even without having the object itself, and whether I have no desire for the object, because I already contented, then there is no more. That is the supreme, because there is no anxiety to get it, and there is no anxiety to preserve it, because in the process of getting the object, there are several other problems that are there. One is the struggling hard to get it, and the other is to maintain that what I got is also another struggle, because I want millions, and when I am in trying to get a million, and the struggle to it, and once I got it, then maintain that status quo itself is a problem, because there are a lot of other people who are looking for the same thing, and therefore preservation of what I got, and also there is a loss, if I lose, then I suffering. So all dosha, all the pains are there, dukkha mishritatvam are there, and there is a asantruptikaram. But even if I got it, there is a desire, something else to fulfill there comes into picture. Whereas if it is a virakti, that means I have dispassion for all of them, then whether I get it or not, there is a immaterial, my mind is contented even without it also. So whether it comes or not doesn't matter to me. So therefore, Upanishad talks about sotriyasya akamayatasya. So the one who is sotriya akamayaha, he is already happy without anything also. So mahattamam virakti tu vidyanande tadiritam. So virakti, in the dispassion, to indeed mahattamam. So taratama, that means this is the highest, the happiness that you get, most extreme happiness, and this comes only by knowing that I am as I am, complete and full. That means I am a ananda swarupa, that means I am fulfilled as I am. So prajahati yada kaman sarvan partha manogatan, I have no more desire for it, and therefore sotriyasya akamayatasya, I don't have any desire for it, because I am full. If I am feeling empty and I don't have, that's a different story. But I am full as I am, so I have no desire for anything at all, and because I feel fulfillment in life, and therefore it is the contentment that gives you with the knowledge sotriyaha akamayaha. So having just fulfillment is not sufficient. I know that my true nature also, that it is the nature of fullness itself, then it is not momentary, it is permanent. Therefore, the vijyanande tadiritam, this has been discussed in the previous chapter, where the brahmanande vijyanandaha chapter, this was already covered. Iti iritam means has been discussed. एवं शांतौ तथौ तदौदार्ये क्रोध लोभ निवारणात्. सो एवं सिस इन द सेम वे शांतौ इन फॉरगिविंग और नॉट ओनली डिजायर फुलफिलिंग इन फॉरगिवनेस एंड इन पीसफुलनेस एंड तथा औदार्ये इन द लार्ज हार्टेडनेस ऑल्सो द क्रोध लोभ निवारितम. द क्रोध एंगर एंड लोभ greediness, etc., are not there, are absent. So therefore, it will be pure sattvic thoughts only will be coming, and that has been discussed also. And same thing will happen not only in the desires, but also when one has the other divine qualities, that is Devi Sampatti, that Krishna talks about in the 16th and 17th chapters, if I have that, then I am peaceful, serene as I am. That's what essentially, that means sattvic thoughts only are entertained. Go 19.
Yajjat sukham bhavet tat tad. Yajjat sukham bhavet tat tad. Brahmaiva pratibimbanat. Brahmaiva pratibimbanat. Ruttishvantaha mukha swasya. Ruttishvantaha mukha swasya. Nirvignam pratibimbanam. Nirvignam pratibimbanam.
Together.
Yajjat sukham bhavet tat tad brahmaiva pratibimbanam ruttishvantah mukha swasya nirvighnam pratibimbanam
yajjat sukham bhavet. So whenever there is a sukham tat tat, in that only brahma eva pratibimbanam, so it is only the brahman that is only reflected, because if the brahman that is of the nature of happiness gets reflected in the equipments that are the instruments of reflection. Instruments do not have either happy or unhappy. It is the happiness is with the Brahman. So Brahman being happiness because he is Anantatva. Anantatva means he is infinite. Infinite means there is completely full, there is nothing more it needs. That's why Krishna says a Jivan Mukta is completely full as he is, therefore no desires for him. Therefore Atmaniyeva Atmanatushtaha is reveling in himself by himself. So yajjat sukham bhavet tatad brahmaiva pratibimbanat ruttishvantaha. So ruttishu, so tatad brahmaiva prati antarmukhasu ruttishu. So in the introverted mind, antarmukham means in the introverted mind looking on the contemplation of who am I or what is the nature of the reality. So here it is not the sattvic thought, it's not the rajasic thought, it is an inquiring thought. A mind that is in the inquiring mode of trying to find out the truth, not any other relative truth but absolute truth, or trying to find out who is that I am or what is that I am, or abiding in the knowledge of I am, that is antarmukham. So a contemplative mind that is contemplating on the nature of the reality. So even though one has established that is already a sthita prajnaha, but even the one who is trying to realize that state by yoga, that's called the Yoganandaha. One who was in the process of that also gets the same happiness. It says, Antar Mukhasu Vruttishu. In those thoughts, even though they are thoughts, it's not thoughtless state, it's on the thought of I am that, I am that, I am that which is supreme of that, because I am pure existent consciousness and not this neti neti, and try to shift my attention to that I am, that antarmukha su uttishu, in those thoughts pratibimbanam nirvighnam. So the reflection is without any obstruction. So I will be getting without unobstructed happiness in the very dwelling of that also, I am happy. That's why people smile even in the inquiring of the truth. Why smile comes? Because I am looking at the nature of the reality of that right. Therefore, even inquiring into that which is covered in the Brahmanande Yoganandaha, that's in the 11th chapter, I guess, is already being discussed before, is what is being mentioned here. So yajjas sukham nirvignam pratibimbanam. So reflection always will be there without any obstruction, and therefore a one who is in that inquiring mode is also happy as long as the mind is inquiring in that nature. Mind, when the contemplative mind in that state also is a happy mind, whereas once you come back into the earth where you are transacting in the world. If you have not retaining that, then if I get involved, then I still go back to that. So even when I come back, I have to keep memory of that only. Mind has to be dwelling in that, and that is what essentially a Jivan Mukta is. We'll stop with that and come back again.
Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi.